Hello and welcome to another video. In today's video, I have to make a video because the comments are turned off on this video here that the public broadcasting service shouldn't be allowed to turn off their comments because it's the public broadcasting service. So anyway, I have to make this video, so stay tuned.
Matt McCaw is the spokesman for the Greater Idaho Movement, which wants to break off the eastern, more conservative counties in Oregon and join neighboring Idaho.
You get out here on the east side, and it's high desert.
Okay, so this guy wants to be the leader, or is the leader, of a movement. And one of the first things out of his mouth is, this is a high desert. And that's simply not true. There is absolutely no such thing as a high desert. A high desert is not a type of area. This is steppe. And these people that are clamoring to be in charge have actually been mismanaging the land so bad, it's turning into an actual desert. So just think about that for a second. So this guy, who doesn't even know what type of area he lives in, wants to be in charge. He has no clue that he lives on steppe. He thinks he lives in some kind of desert. But we should be taking him seriously?
This is the time period when people in rural areas start to feel like the economy is bottoming out. Once you get into the 2000s, and they feel that these policies are being hoisted upon them,
urban areas, Mettler says, were able to bounce back more quickly from economic downturns. That fueled resentment from those in rural areas that account for about 20% of the U.S. population.
That's when we start to see this politics of grievance and resentment. People in rural places started to feel that the Democratic Party was run by elites, people who were better off than them.
This woman is failing to note is the rise of Fox News and of right-wing radio. They, being Clear Choice, literally took Portland's rock station and turned it into a conservative talk radio. So now, in Portland, so this is Portland, I knew people that hadn't been political their entire lives. I'd been voting since I was 18, okay? These people never voted, they never nothing. And all of a sudden, they all had opinions on everything, out of the blue. Well, what it was is they used to listen to rock music, then Clear Channel turned the rock station into Rush Limbaugh, and now you had a bunch of people just being fed their opinions. They weren't their own opinions. They were Rush Limbaugh's opinions. And all of a sudden I watched this live in people that I considered friends listening, spewing this stuff. This is what happened to rural America, was right-wing radio, was Fox News. And this lady doesn't seem to have a clue about that. So she's kind of a sus educator, right?
They're destroying their city over there.
That's simply not true. I made a whole video about this. Portland was destroyed by fascists. The same fascists that tried to overthrow our country, the Proud Boys, were showing up in Portland starting fights for years, all the way up until past COVID. So no, fascists destroyed Portland. We, Portlanders, didn't destroy Portland. People came to Portland to destroy it. Most likely, possibly some of this guy's friends. Look at the invasion video.
And they said, well, we don't need ranchers or farmers. This lady actually thought you can go to your butcher and tell him what you want, and he pushes a button in a machine and out comes her meat.
How do you even have a conversation with a person that just lies to you like this? This man expects everybody that's watching this program to believe that somebody actually thinks that cows come from a button. Now, here's my opinion on liars, okay? If you lie to me, you're disrespecting me, okay? If you don't have enough respect for me to tell me the truth, then, and I catch you in a lie, that's pretty much the end of me listening to you, wanting to talk to you, wanting to be your friend, having any respect for you at all. It's over. This guy wants to just lie to everyone to push his narrative. That's how bad his narrative is. That's how little value his opinion has, because he has to bolster it with lies. Okay? So it's time for to IQ test the population. It's time just to let people know how big their brains are for real. This guy has grown up in the middle of nowhere, was handed everything by his parents. All he knows is race, and that's good. I don't have a problem with any of that. I think it's awesome he raises cows. As long as he's doing it in a humane way, I'm totally supportive of that. I eat beef all the time. Okay, but he thinks because he has this whole cow thing figured out and he's an expert at cows that I automatically makes him an expert at everything. That's what he thinks in his head. It's called Dunning-Kruger effect. We literally cannot move forwards when we have people that have a little teeny, teeny, tiny bit of information in their brain that they learned from a lifetime of dealing with like cows. And all of a sudden they think that makes them an authority on everything. It's just simply not true. This man lies. He lied to you. He lied to everyone. And basically he should just be ignored as a liar. All right. Turn on your comments, PBS NewsHour, so I don't have to make videos like this. Like, subscribe, peace. Thank you for watching.